Sisters, as we remember the introduction of our salvation through the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, let us now reflect on the fifth utterance of Jesus Christ on the cross. And this utterance is contained in John chapter 19, verse 28, namely, "I am thirsty." This utterance may be understood in two different contexts. And the first one is the physical context of humanity. That was possible with Jesus Christ because he was fully human. It was almost 6 hours Jesus Christ was hung on the cross when he spoke the seven words. Most definitely, his human aspect to suffer on the cross had been affected. And that was in actual fact the rationale for his humanity, to suffer on our behalf. However, let us focus on the second context, which is the spiritual context of his thirst. And that spiritual context is to save the world. The phrase before this fifth utterance suggests that the focus of Jesus Christ was actually on the spiritual context when he uttered these words. John links the utterance, "I am thirsty," to the fulfillment of the scriptures. Throughout his stay on earth, Jesus Christ had suffered the wrath of God against sin, particularly on the cross, for one purpose: to save us, to make salvation possible for all people. Now, while on the cross, Jesus Christ realized that it is finished, that the prophecy of Psalm 22 verse 15 was being fulfilled, that salvation is being actualized. The phrase "I am thirsty" further highlights the infinite love of Jesus Christ for us, that he was prepared to suffer the burning thirst in order to be the fountain of living water for us, so that ultimately we can be assured of salvation. Oh yes, brothers and sisters, through Jesus Christ as our everlasting fountain of living water, we are guaranteed everlasting salvation. Remember, you were created for the purpose of making God happy. And it is only through embracing Jesus Christ as your fountain of living water, through accepting him as your personal savior, and through living your life in accordance with God's will, that you would make God happy and be guaranteed of God's mercy, blessings, and everlasting salvation. Brothers and sisters, even in this critical situation where humanity is being attacked by the coronavirus, while we are observing all measures in the war against it, such as staying at home during the lockdown period, washing our hands with soap all the time, let us not lose hope, because the only fountain of living water, Jesus Christ, is on our side. In Romans chapter 8, verse 31, the word of God says, "If God is on our side, who can be against?" Be wise and do likewise and be saved. God bless you all. Amen.